common heresy is that Jesus is not God, that he's just an angel or a prophet or some created being, but not God, or that his existence only began about 2,000 years ago when he was born in Bethlehem. Well, you know, why don't we start with that?
Okay, let's have a look at the first few verses of John's Gospel. Mm-hmm. We read this, beginning at verse 1, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made." Now we could ask the question here, who or what is the Word that's mentioned here?
Right. Well, obviously a who. It's a who,
it's
right?
A who, yes.
Since John calls the Word he was with God in the beginning. The key to answering that question is found in verse 14, where it says, "And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us."
Okay.
Right? Yeah. Clearly, that's Jesus, all right? So Jesus became flesh. He became a human in order to be a perfect substitute for humans, taking our sins on himself so that all those who believe don't need to pay for their own sins. That's a key component to the gospel.
Yeah, substitutionary atonement.
Yep.
So now that we know that Jesus is the Word, let's go back and insert Jesus where appropriate. Let's read this again. So in the beginning was Jesus, and Jesus was with God, mm-hmm. and Jesus was God. Right. Jesus was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Jesus, and without Jesus was not anything made that was made. Right. From that single verse alone, the doctrine of the Trinity is inevitable.